गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऋषिकुल ऑनलाइन स्कूल। लेट्स कंटिन्यू चैप्टर नंबर 8 ऑफ हिस्ट्री, नेम्ड एजुकेशन अंडर द ब्रिटिश रूल। दिस इज़ द थर्ड मॉड्यूल ऑफ द चैप्टर एंड इन दिस मॉड्यूल वी शैल स्टडी अबाउट द इंडियन एजुकेशनिस्ट हु मेड एफर्ट्स फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन इन इंडिया। राजा राम मोहन रॉय एंड रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर, they were the main pioneers of educational reforms in India. Raja Ram Mohan Roy, he was very well acquainted with the Hindu scriptures, the Vedas and the Upanishads. He was a linguist and had studied Sanskrit, Persian, Arabic, English, Latin and Greek languages. He also had a deep knowledge of Christianity and had written a book titled The Percepts of Jesus. He was in favor of imparting Western education to Indians. Swami Dayanand Saraswati, he was the founder of Arya Samaj, who sought to revive the ancient glory and religion of the Aryans. The Arya Samaj, it was founded in 1875. He gave the slogan Back to Vedas. To promote education, he started a number of Dayanand Anglo-Vedic, that is DAV schools in many parts of India. Mrs. Annie Besant, she was elected president of the Theosophical Society in 1907. The society was deeply influenced with the Hindu philosophy of karma. It worked for the universal brotherhood and humanity. Mrs. Besant led the foundation of the Central Hindu College in 1898. Next, Pandit Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar. He took forward the cause of women education. He was associated with at least 35 girl schools in Bengal. He was principal of the Sanskrit College and devised new approach and methods of teaching Sanskrit. Next is about the Satish Chandra Mukherjee, who laid the foundation of Dawn Society in 1902. The society laid emphasis on the development of character and feelings of nationalism. Mukherjee also organized the National Council of Education, NCE, in 1906. The main features of this National Council of Education, it is as under: emphasis on easy learning by imparting education in vernacular languages. Second, English education was set as a compulsory second language. Technical education, it was provided up to 5th standard. Physical and natural sciences, arts, culture and humanities, these subjects were also taught. Provisions for research and higher studies in ancient Indians, history, philosophy, economics, politics, arts and sciences increased. Rabindranath Tagore. Tagore highly disliked the four walls of his classroom wherein students looked like prisons. Therefore, he dreamt of setting up a school where children were not bound to sit in classes or study a particular curriculum. He preferred a creative and natural environment for the children. With these views in mind, Tagore set up his school called Shanti Niketan. Mahatma Gandhi, he was against the westernization of Indian education. According to him, Indians were becoming the slaves of Western education, thought and culture. They neglected the rich Indian culture and traditions. Mahatma Gandhi advocated Nayi Taleem, that is basic education program, which combined crafts, arts, health and education. He was always in favor of education to be in mother tongue. So this was all about this module. We will continue the chapter in the next module. Have a nice day.